Manila City again temporarily suspends administering first dose of COVID jabs in mass vaccination sites as it used up the remaining supply allocated for it Saturday.
Today, wala tayong bakunahan ng first dose. Puro second dose lang tayo ngayon. Meron tayong pailan-ilang doses na siyang ating sineserve katulad ng home service. At saka yung mga may special na sakit.
The city will procure 400,000 additional COVID vaccine doses on top of the 800,000 AstraZeneca doses expected to be delivered in September. Marikina City has also consumed its supply of AstraZeneca first doses and expects to roll out all remaining Pfizer first doses Monday. The city appeals for additional COVID vaccine doses as it sees the supply of Sinovac first doses to be depleted in 3 days.
Nakikita natin yung mataas na vaccine confidence ng mga tao, lalo na kung maraming pinagpipili ang uri ng bakuna. At nakikita nila na tuloy-tuloy tayo sa pagbabakuna at nakikita nila na ang maraming iba't ibang tao na nagpapabakuna ngayon.
Quezon City, meanwhile, sought permission from the National Task Force Against COVID-19 to use as first dose half of its Sinovac supply allocated for second dose. It has used up all Pfizer and AstraZeneca first doses.
Since alam naman natin na may padating na Sinovac, kasi nga gusto ko tuloy-tuloy at kulang na yung bakuna, pinayagan naman tayo, no? After that is finished, hopefully dumating na yung bulto-bulto na pinangako nila.
The Department of Health says Metro Manila cities can begin using the 500,000 Sinovac doses delivered last Thursday once its certificate of analysis arrives from the manufacturer within the week. Vaccine Czar Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr. previously said he expected 2.2 million additional Pfizer COVID vaccine doses from the COVAX facility and 1.3 million Sputnik V doses to arrive in the Philippines within the month. Over 10 more million COVID vaccine doses are expected to be delivered this June. And according to the DOH, 40 million Pfizer doses procured by the government may arrive third quarter of the year. Data from the National Task Force Against COVID-19 show that the Philippines has administered over 4 million doses since March until May 22nd. Less than a million, or 1.36% of the target 70 million Filipinos, completed the two doses, while 3.1 million received the first dose. The NTF says COVID vaccination in the Philippines accelerated to more than 162,000 jabs a day. Galvez is confident the Philippines can double this rate in June as long as vaccine supply is steady. The World Health Organization urges Filipinos to strictly comply with COVID vaccination protocols to ensure equitable access to COVID vaccines.
Overall, we are very encouraged by the vaccine rollout. We recognize that there have been a few lapses, but those are not systemic lapses that have happened, but individuals violating the clear protocols that have been adopted by the National Vaccine Operations Center and the government.
ABS-CBN data analytics head Edson Guido says at the current pace, the Philippines can reach its target of inoculating 70 million Filipinos in more than 2 years or until 2023. But Galvez says the government targets to ramp up vaccinations to 500,000 doses a day to achieve herd immunity within the year. The Department of Science and Technology, meanwhile, eyes to begin next month clinical trials on mixing different COVID vaccine brands for the first and second doses. DOSD Secretary Fortunato de la Peña says this will be held in 8 areas: Rizal, Manila, Pasig, Makati or Pasay, Muntinlupa, Quezon City, Cebu and Davao, with 1,200 participants. The study will focus on mixing Sinovac with other brands as the country has a steady supply of the former vaccine.
Hindi lamang siya kamukha nung pag-oobserba sa pagbabakuna na mauupuin ka lang at oobserbahan. Ito po ay titingnan yung mga adverse events na pwedeng mangyari, imamonitor at i-evaluate pa po yan yung safety assessment. Tapos ang antibody test ay gagawin 5 beses sa isang pasyente at iba't ibang panahon, iba't ibang petsa.
The study will be conducted for 18 months. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.